know I can sing opera.
Yep.
Go ahead. I am Alicia Halliday Ross. These are my two daughters, Jennifer Ross and Sarah Ross. They are twins. They are 6 years old and they attend school, first grade, in where we live in New Jersey.
So do you guys take science?
Yeah.
You take science at school? No.
Yeah. One of you guys.
So she was three. They were in a preschool and their preschool was telling me that some of Sarah's kind of sensory behaviors and some of her meltdowns were more than they could manage. So I took her to my pediatrician who said, this is beyond the scope of my abilities. And so we ended up going to a neurodevelopmental pediatrician who, after many days and hours of thorough examination, gave her a diagnosis of autism spectrum disorder.
So your family is enrolled in the Autism Sisters Project, right?
Yes, the goal of the Autism Sisters Project is to identify as many sisters of both boys and girls with autism as possible so that we can understand what makes girls more resilient.
So the Autism Sisters Project is a project that came out in a collaboration between us and the Autism Science Foundation. We've known basically since autism was first described that it's much more common in boys than girls. So when you look at girls with autism and boys with autism, you find that the girls have twice as many mutations as the boys do. And that tells us that they're resistant. And if you found a girl that had the same number of mutations as a boy, she may not have autism. So when a family arrives here to join in the study, we get saliva from everybody, and then we do some assessments of the family to understand what traits are in the family and help us kind of build a picture of both the genetic and the behavioral aspects of the family.
You just spit into the cup. We want your spit. That's all. What do you think?
I can't.
It's kind of our third game. It's a little bit of a silly game.
It's called spit in the cup.
Exactly.
Because there's cells in your cheeks and they have your DNA in them.
So what are some genetic factors that may lead to one child, a girl having a diagnosis or a boy having a diagnosis, but the sister not having the diagnosis? What's going on in those girls? Now, if we knew what those genes were and what those genes did, you can take whatever that is in a laboratory and you can define it and you can develop it, and then you can turn it into something that can be given to anybody. And for some people with autism, that means, you know, protecting against being nonverbal or who are self-injurious. So can you protect against or prevent those symptoms while still keeping, you know, all of the things that make a lot of people with autism so wonderful?
Do you like to dance?
I like to dab.